And here's Rihanna.
Hey.
Hi. How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm really good, thanks. On the live webcam now at bbc.co.uk/radio1. Check out the red, really red hair. Look at it. It's amazing.
You like?
I like.
Thank you.
Yeah. So you got straight off the plane yesterday from New York.
Yeah.
And you went straight into a photo shoot.
Yes, we did actually two photo shoots. We did one for Q and one for Mary Claire.
You're always working.
Yeah.
Like all the time. I'm saying this as a concerned fan. Because there really isn't a time when you haven't got a song out, is there? I was just thinking about this earlier. You're never going to be able to have a comeback because you're always there.
You know what? I love making music. Music is what I do, so I don't feel like there should be a break unless I choose to take a break, you know? Mm. Like, there's no such thing as taking a break if you don't want to. I'm here to make music.
Yeah. And you've got your fifth album coming out.
Yes, my fifth. I can't believe it's the fifth album already.
Yeah.
That's insane to think about.
You churn them out, don't you, Rihanna? It's brilliant.
Well, thank you so much. Yeah. This one, I'm definitely... I've never been this excited about anything I've done creatively, and this is it's just the perfect Rihanna album.
Okay, why?
Every song is tailored to me. Like, I wanted songs on there that were all Rihanna songs that nobody else could do. Like, I didn't want the generic pop record that Kesha or Lady Gaga or Katy Perry could just do, you know, and everybody, it'll work. Mm. I wanted songs that were that were Rihanna songs that only I could do. Had that little West Indian vibe to it. Had a certain tone, a certain sass, and a certain energy.
I guess there are quite a lot of songs that do sound quite similar at the moment that could just be anybody.
Yeah. And especially with pop music, it's really easy to do that because of the whole dance music movement happening right now. And, you know, it's just easy to get a dance beat and just throw a song on top of it and call it a hit.
Yeah, okay.
I wanted songs on there that were all Rihanna songs that nobody else could do. Like, I didn't want the generic pop record that Kesha or Lady Gaga or Katy Perry could just do, you know, and everybody, it'll work. Mm. I wanted a song that, or songs that were that were Rihanna songs that only I could do. Had that little West Indian vibe to it. Had a certain
what I really want to ask you about is Katy Perry's bachelorette party.
I bet.
Yeah, I do. Now, you and Katy are good friends, aren't you?
Yes.
We call them hen parties here.
I know.
What happens? Hen party.
It was really, really fun. Like, it was chaotic. The moment we landed in Vegas, we never stopped moving until the moment we left. And we just went to the pool, we went to see a show, we went to dinner, we went to the club, strip club, and then we went to the tables for a minute, and then I got on a plane and went to work to shoot Only Girl in the World's music video.
And nobody wore L plates like they do here.
What's that?
L plates, like for learner drivers.
Like, is it? No.
Yeah.
Oh, that's funny.
I didn't see any pictures of you with them on. Or any dealy boppers on your head.
I never heard about that, actually.
Oh, devil horns, sometimes they wear. And normally,
actually, there were a few other bachelorettes in the building.
There were?
At times. Uh-huh. And every one of them had on devil horns on their head.
Yeah. You also have to laugh really loudly like this. And normally drink Bacardi Breezes. Are you making a film as well?
Yes, I'm actually currently filming Battleship. Right now, we have a break from the movie, but I'll be back in November to wrap that up after the album comes out. But it's been really, really good so far. Working with Peter Berg has been unbelievable, and I love doing movies now.
What was working with Eminem like?
Amazing. I mean, I hadn't really gotten to work with him until after we recorded the song.
Mm.
So when we started to perform it together, and really, he's just really a really cool guy, really interesting. He's really laid back, but he just is so mysterious. Like, it makes you really curious about what's going on in his mind.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
Did you want to question him at length about things?
Yeah. Like, I feel like I could ask him a million questions in a day.
Really?
Yeah.
Did you do it?
No, of course not.
Do you feel like you want to?
Yeah, but I feel like there's a reason why he's so mysterious, because he doesn't want to let that information out.
Oh, okay. You know? So you still don't feel like you really know him?
Yeah, I feel like I understand him.
Hmm.
You know, I get that he's a private person, and he's really cool. He's just really laid back. He's really reserved.
There's a lot going on up there, though.
Definitely.
Yeah, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.